Welcome back to my channel, friends. This is Sonia here from Growing Craft, and I'm so excited to do this video. I always say that I'm so excited, and I'm really so excited whenever I do a video. I absolutely love it. I really enjoy interacting with you all while making my video. Ideally, I was supposed to do this live video with the voice over, but I couldn't do it because of the coronavirus thing. Like, my daughter is at home, my husband is working from home, and it is really difficult to shoot with the voiceover. So here I'm recording my voice now, and so yes, as you can already see that I am going to alter a decoupage. I'm going to make a decoupage artwork on this pot. So this is an old pot which was there on my garden, and I really don't like the plain black pots. I really wish to make over to all the pots which I have there, which is not possible for me because few of them are really big and heavy, but I am trying to. Now here to prep up my base, I am using gesso. So I just felt that at times that applying a coat of gesso becomes really difficult, especially with this camlin one, because if they dry out even a bit, they become really thicker. So here I'm just adding a few drops of water, and I am going to apply good 2-3 coats of gesso unless until I get the exact base what I need for my work. Now whenever we do decoupage, it's always preferable to work with a plain white surface, but I have even done the decoupage without using any white base. Like, I have worked it on the colorful pots and they look absolutely amazing. Now for this one, I wanted a particularly the white base. Why I needed a white base? Because I wanted to work with some really nice cool and bright colors, which was not possible to get in the black color. So that's the reason I'm prepping up my base. Now if you want, you can try with the acrylic paints also, but then definitely the look and feel is going to be a bit different. I have done few of the videos with the difference between acrylic and gesso, and then acrylic paint and chalk paint. So you can scroll down to my channel and see all those videos, and I really hope that all those videos will be helpful for you all. Now as you can see that I'm doing all the quick coats of gesso here. It is just because I have used the water, so drying this with my heat gun is super easy. It is drying out really fast. So as soon as I finish my one coat of layer, I move on to the next. I just dry it out and then I move on to the next layer. So this is how I have done almost 3-4 layers of gesso in this. And I don't need to mention that I have used a white gesso to make sure that my base color comes out really well, and it makes easier for me to pop out my colors well. Now one more thing that I should have or I could have used sponge dauber also here, but I prefer to use a flat brush because it is going to give a very good coverage, and like I said that I wanted to have 2-3 coats, with brush it's much easier. Now it's time to do the fussy cutting work. Yes, you heard me right. I think I'm just getting addicted to the fussy cutting work, and yes, in this one I have planned to do the fussy cut of this beautiful flower bunch which is there. So I am going to trim the sound as much as I can. Now here is a very quick tip. Whenever you are choosing a picture for your fussy cutting work, try to make sure that the picture size is big and the less detailing it has on the outer side, so that it's easier for you to do the fussy cutting work. Now if you choose any intricate design with too much of detailing on the borders, it is going to be really difficult for you to cut out. If you are really good in fussy cutting work, you can definitely do it, but for me, I just felt that this design was good. Something similar of this design is going to be really good for me to do fussy cutting work. Anyways, I wanted to create something with a floral pattern. I've already done a decoupage on a flower pot. That was not with the exact fussy cutting work, but yeah, that was again in the floral theme only, and I absolutely love that pot. It is there inside my bedroom next to my side table, and I love it. So I just feel that with this same pots what you have in your house, you can create and give them a new look and use it, and they are going to add some more extra charm to your house.
deux doigts de nos lèvres, deux doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter, le bonheur à sculpter de son ciseau d'orfèvre.
Now, once I'm done with my fussy cutting work, it's time to do my decoupage work. Here I'm using my DIY decoupage glue. Video tutorial is already there on my channel on how to make a decoupage glue, and you can check that, and I've also shared the links down below. Now, while sticking this, I'm going to be a little careful. I have also done few of the extra cutting of the leaves as you have seen. So, I'm just going to make sure that I stick it as a bunch of flower with the leaves on almost all the sides. So, in few of the places it is going to overlap with my flower, but then it's absolutely fine. This is going to give it a much more of a natural look. And anyways, I have planned to do some more work on this, and that will take care of all the overlapping of my decoupage napkins here, and this looks beautiful. Now this has not dried out completely, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my heat gun and I'm going to dry this up. Now while using my heat gun, I'll also just try to make sure that wherever I feel that I need to add some adhesive or I need to remove the wrinkles, I will do that without having a second thought, because of course you need to have very less wrinkles, then only your project looks really really beautiful. Now if you want, you can use a plastic sheet to press your decoupage stick napkin, or even you can use a sponge dauber. I personally like using sponge dauber a lot. I absolutely love it, and they just make sure that everything dries out well. Now here is a quick tip that when you are doing your varnish work, this actually seals up your napkin. Now you must be thinking that why you need to seal up your paper with the varnish. Now like I said, I'm going to play with the different mediums on this one. So here I just want to make sure that whatever the colors or the mediums I use is not absorbed by my napkin at all. Now just to make sure of that, I'm applying a generous amount of varnish on my napkin, and I'm trying to make sure that I apply my varnish on my napkin only, so that when I apply the colors and I apply the different mediums, they don't smudge and my napkin does not absorb those colors at all, and my napkin looks as it is. So here, just be a little careful, and very easily you can do that. This looks difficult, but this is really interesting, and only on the border sides you have to be a little careful, otherwise it's just perfect for you to do the varnish work. And before you start with the other mediums, make sure that your varnish has dried out completely. Now with the heat gun, I'm speeding up all of my process of drying. This is such a fab tool which I feel that every crafter should have. Like heat gun really helps in drying up your project. Now it's time to play with the colors, and I have decided to use a chalk paint. I am just adding some water splashes on the sides. This is just to make sure that my color spreads out really well. I just want to give it a very natural and shady blue look. So with a round brush, I'm spreading my colors, and as you can see that even if some of my colors are going on the napkin, if I just wipe it out, it's just cleaning, coming out so nicely and so beautifully, and that's the reason we had used the varnish there. Now I'm going to repeat the same process of coloring on the complete pot, and like I said, I want a shady effect, so I'm going to add water and my color and just blend it really well on my background.
pas de doigts de nos lèvres, de doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter, le bonheur à sculpter de son ciseau d'enfer, des souvenirs impossibles à effacer. Le bonheur est passé à deux doigts de nos lèvres, de doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter, le bonheur à sculpter de son ciseau d'enfer, des souvenirs impossibles à effacer.
My pot has dried out completely. It's looking beautiful. I just thought of doing a nice polka dot thing. I was not really sure that what size of dots I'm looking for, and while I started doing this video, I just knew that I need to add some more pink shade to it. So here, when I'm done with taking out my colors, I'm just adding few drops of water to it to make it a little thinner. And with that, I'm going to give it a nice border on my pot completely. So on the top and the bottom lid, I am going to just run my brush. And there is so much of water in my brush that it is going to run out really, really, really smoothly on my pot. So once I'm done with this, now I'm going to add polka dots with the same shade. Yes, this is looking absolutely gorgeous. You can see the pictures at the end. I'm sharing all the pictures of my artwork at the end, and trust me, in person also this spot looks beautiful. I'm super happy. A big pat on my back, and I really, really love this one. So yes, of course, this is one of the way of adding the different texture to your pot. You can use different mediums, you can use different colors. I have used chalk paints because I wanted to use chalk paint. You can try out the metallic paints, the acrylic paints, the shimmer paints, the gold touch paints, and they are going to look really, really fab. Now with just my sponge dauber backside, I'm adding dots here. You can do some kind of stamping work and then fill in the colors, even though those are also going to look really, really beautiful. Now once we are done with this, we need to make sure that it dries out really well so that we can seal this up. So my project has dried out completely and it's looking beautiful, absolutely gorgeous. And here I'm using my varnish, and I'm going to have good 2-3 coats of varnish on my project, and I will make sure that after each coat of varnish I'll make it dry for good like 1 or 2 days, and then I'm going to seal it up again with second or and my third coat of varnish. So yes, with this my project is done. Of course, I'm listing down all the supplies down in the description box. Do check that and do check the pictures at the end so that you can see all the detailings really well. And if you have any queries, please do comment below. I'll be more than happy to help you all. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Take care. Bye bye.